Right. See you later.
Okay, we're here at the People's Gym, Kieran Farrell's gym. Great to see you, mate.
Good to see you, Chris. Good to see you, mate.
So, you know, you've been busy, haven't you? Obviously, you're training, you're managing, you're promoting, you've had some shows on. You've got another show coming up.
And, yes.
Double title fights on there.
Yeah, mate, I've got the 29th of September at the Macron Stadium, which is a bit of a risk, really, with financially, because all it is the shows, like the smaller shows, they cost like a little bit less, and this one's pretty expensive. But I thought, well, it's called rolling the dice. The lads are rolling the dice. They've got title fights. They've got good hard fights. George Brennan versus Zayed Hussain, top featherweight clash. 14-0 Zayed Hussain, and George is the home fighter. George is the home fighter. Is stepping up, mate, a bit similar to what I did when I was with Dave Cole when I fought Joel Feed. He was 7-0 unbeaten and no one had fight him, and Zayed's had the same problem. No, he can't get a good opponent for this title. Like, look, well, George moved up to featherweight, he's ready for it, and we're going to do it, mate. I'm going to put it out there, mate. I think George knocks him out.
Well, a few of the lads are in here tonight. You've actually, and Zahid are here as well.
Yeah, both here, yeah.
So maybe you can grab a word with them two together and see, you know.
Definitely.
Let's speak to some of the other lads. Introduce us to who's
Yes. Come in the gym. So, we've got Ben Thomas, who's been making his pro debut. He's a local lad from Bolton. I've known Ben years through the amateurs and mate, it was close to hanging the gloves up. I actually invited him to my last show, and he said he's looking to turn pro himself. So that's what we did, mate. We got him in here, and we got it started. And been in front of the board. He's got his medicals to do next, and fingers crossed, subject to British Border Control. Once he's all cleared and that, it's good to go, mate. And I'm very excited about it, mate. He's got some massive power. He's been in the ring with Dimitri Bivol as an amateur. He's a WBC light heavyweight champion. And he's held his own with these sort of fighters. Mate, he's going places. The lad's going places. And like I say, I'm well excited. I've been coming to the gym now for 6 years doing training with all the fighters. And can say right at the minute, Chris, probably one of the most exciting times coming to the gym to train the pros and to have a look at them. Do our training with my brother, and I'm managing and taking the managing role serious, but mate, I have my input, you know what I mean? I have my input, I say what I think, and mate, it's exciting, you know what I mean? Do you want to see some more of the fighters? Ben Ridings, who'll be making his debut as well. Another really exciting addition, what we've got in the gym. Ben's, he's come over here, Ben. A bit of sparred with the likes of Comrade Cummins.
Alright, how you doing, you buddy?
Sparred with the likes of Comrade Cummins, and I was held in his own, and I said to Ben, we're getting nowhere with this amateur, because everyone's pulling out. He's got a good amateur record, he won 8 and lost 2, but he's relatively a novice, you know what I mean? But we knew that he could fight, and we knew that he could hold his own with WBO European champion Comrade Cummins at the time. Daryl Sharp, he spars Daryl Sharp regular, and that's always good to watch. And obviously with Ben Thomas as well, both making a debut, they're both similar weights. Ben's a middleweight, and he's never had a bar of chocolate in his life. That's a fact. That's a fact.
That's it.
Ben over here with
perfect. Yeah, like Kieran said, you know, I came in sole purposely to do amateur again, because I was out of the game for like 2 years. That's all I wanted to do is amateur. It didn't even cross my mind to turn pro. Obviously, Kay's, he had a look at me, and obviously, Kay's brother Nathan. He thought I was good enough, so they thought they'd put me in the deep end, you know, spar these top lads, and I did that. I held my own. Obviously, I had quite a few things to work on, because that was just the beginning, but ever since Nathan's been training me, I've been spot on, haven't I?
Yeah, it's been really good, mate. It's been really good, like I say.
I did well in the amateurs.
In the amateurs, fighting 9 fights, weren't it?
Yeah, it was 9 or 10 fights, and he'd only lost 2.
Yeah, three of them was regionals, so I got a lot of buys, but a lot of them was regionals.
Pro debut. That's why it's an exciting time, because like we've got Ben Thomas, we've got Ben Ryan, and then we've got We've got like the two lads fighting for the titles, and we've got, obviously we spoke a little bit earlier about George fighting Zayed Hussain in a very tough test, and then Lee Clayton, he's come all the way up and he's fighting for the bantamweight title now. So Lee's had one of them rainbow of a career. He got dropped, he got knocked out of a Latvian lad who actually had a real good amateur record, and then we rebuilt him and we showed him what a loss is not the end of the world, you know what I mean? And then he's come back and he's had four or five good performances since. What's it called? He's now fighting Craig Derbyshire, who I class as the Daryl Sharp of the bantamweights, you know what I mean? So he's got an hard fight and he's got to take it serious, and that's what Lee's doing now. He's putting the work in and he's taking it serious. We've got Conor Lynch as well. Conor beat an unbeaten kid last time out. He didn't need to take the challenge, but he didn't bat an eyelid. I said he's 2-0 this kid. I said you beat him. Nathan said you beat him, and as it was, I went in and beat him, mate. And it was an entertaining fight. It was really good. I really enjoyed it. And Conor, again, he's a man of few words, so we'll leave him out. But he's looking at business, mate. He come back on a Monday. He fought on a Friday, and he's back in the gym on Monday. He's sitting in me shredded. He's got a 10-pack, mate. He's got a 10-pack. Who else is there? Safe Cheeman is walked in. Yes, brother, you're right. So he's just walked in. He's another lad from Bradford. He's from Bradford, aren't you, bro?
Dewsbury.
So it's round that area, though, isn't it?
Yeah,
So there's going to be a lot of support coming from the Yorkshire way with the two lads, and that's what I sort of wanted it for. And he's fighting Sam Amidi, so he's fighting my guy, you know what I mean? Yeah. Which Sam's out in Thailand taking his fight serious, mate. He's out training in Thailand. He just wanted to go and refocus, and that's what Sam did at the start of the year. He got the win over Sam Wixen, who was 6-1, and come back, mate, and he fought Glenn Foote, who was the Commonwealth title champion at light welter, and he didn't do himself any harm at all. He got in there and he's shown that he can mix it with that sort of calibre. So Jason McClory is his manager, and Jason said that he's up for the challenge of fighting Sam, and he said, let's fucking do it, you know what I mean? And I like to be working with lads like that, you know what I mean? It's good. Mate, we want entertaining fights, you know what I mean? We don't want this bullshit like, oh, let's have Journeyman versus Prosper. Let's put good fighters together, you know what I mean? I know Sam Amidi's not got the best record and stuff like that, but mate, he'll come and fight, and fair play to Safe in his third fight, he's going to fight him. And fair play to all the lads. Look, Zayed and George again, they're two lads who don't need to have this fight, but they're going to do it, you know what I mean? Let's do it.
As an amateur, I boxed the best in the country. And when I turned pro, I said to Jason, I go, look, I don't want no easy fight. I don't want to start off easy with the journeyman. Get me some better fights. I want someone who's going to be competitive. And Sam Amidi, I watch him, he brings it.
And you know what I said? I was speaking to Sam the other day and that, and I said, we talk about the experience and that. Sam boxed live on Sky Sports in front of 10,000 people in the arena. I said, mate, that you will come on loads from that. So, mate, we're hoping, look, obviously from my side of things, I'm hoping that Sam can pull it off. And from Safe side of things, like, look, we wish him the best of luck. There's no bullshit here. There's no bad talk. It's just straight up.
Let's wait, time to pull it off, though, yeah?
Yeah, well, mate, look, it is what it is. Like, it's all good. We're not...
Your
pro career up to now?
Pro career, I boxed about 6 months ago. My pro debut, I forgot what his name is now.
Tell him, who's that boxer? Who's that boxer?
Paul Lavelle. He had about 3 months.
2 seconds, actually.
Yeah. 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 The second round, last week I boxed Jason Granham, I think it was. And he was the newest from Journeyman. I give a bit of weight away, I give about 4 kg away, and before that, I have to give myself away. But obviously, with a wake up call, I got to go in that fight. With a wake up call, and
No, a draw to Jordan Granham there's nothing wrong with that. What people don't know is he might not have the best professional record, but he actually was undefeated 26-0 as an amateur.
He won that in good fight.
Yeah, he made a good fight.
Yeah, no, he won that in good fight, so I know the next team's journeyman.
Yeah.
So what I'm saying, when you were in there, you ended up with a scrap. He won't fit as much as I did. And a lot of journeymen come back to get paid, he had to come to the And we both got into a scrap before then, so end up as a draw. I thought I did enough. It is what it is. You live and then you come back stronger.
Yes, mate, it's going to be a good fight. And like I say, look, we wish save the best of luck, you know what I mean?
Yeah, great to
meet you. Sorted. Good man. Finger's going to get you in a minute, mate. Up there, sure. Right, so the next on the bill is the Spartan, Jake Barton. Mate, exciting kid. And he's actually got a green belt already, mate. He has a world title green belt, a WBC Muay Thai belt.
We met, didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
Yes. And mate, you know what, he had an injury, so he had to come out of that fight. But then he fought 4 weeks later, was it? Five, six weeks later, yeah. on his manager's show, Neil Marsh, and he boxed my guy, Callum Hyde. And now, like I say, none of my guys in the away corner come to lose, they come to give you a fight, and that's what Callum did. Callum come to give him a fight, but mate, and Callum wouldn't be disrespected anyway by saying he was just outclassed that night, you know what I mean? Very good fighter, Jake. He's adapting to the professional game well, he's got a tough test himself on another one of them where he say, look, we've got a guy there who's not got the best record. Jake's had, what was it, three fights now?
Two.
He's 2-0, and he's fighting a guy who's had one fight and lost it. But the kid who was fighting and one fight and lost it, he has ambitions of his own. So with him bringing ambitions of his own, and me the promoter, I'm like, look, I'll be honest, I put it out there, Jake Barton's going to have a good coming out night because he's going to knock him out, that's what I think. Like, I put it out there, sorry to her, you know what I mean, I'll put it out there, you know what I mean.
We spoke that you've got the martial arts background.
Yeah.
Obviously you've now had your debut in boxing. How did you find it on the night, having that and, you know, changing the codes?
Yeah, obviously changing over was you know, a long process, but going through the process with Rob and Dee at the Rydal gym, I feel really good now. The bad habits are starting to go, everything's starting to come a bit more naturally, and I'm, you know, looking forward to making my third appearance as a boxer.
This will be a good show, it sounds like. It's a good fight,
yeah,
as well.
Mate, I'll tell you what, something as well about Dee used to train with me back in Ireland. He used to stay at the house where we used to stay at. We used to stay together, and mate, he's got him loose. He's got him nice and loose now. He might have got in there a bit rigid than that, but he's loose now. He's listening to James Brown, he's fucking, and he's loose in the ring, mate. You know what I mean? He's good, he's feeling good. Yeah. But,
good to see you all.
Yeah, thanks,
all
awesome. Thank you.
See you before.
Yeah. So, mate, you know what? George is here. Do you want to speak to George? Yeah. George Brennan.
Hey George,
how you doing? You alright?
Good, mate. Good. Yeah. So your first title fight coming up this Central Air is. It's a great build. Just talking about it there. How do you see this one going? It's a good contest, mate.
Yeah, you know, I think it's a step up for both of us. But at the end of the night, my hand's getting raised, and that's how it's going to end.
I'm the promoter. I'm going to talk this one up, but mate, it is what it is. Zaid's coming, he's getting knocked out, mate. That's that, you know what I mean? Well, look, I've got, like I say, we're not saying anything bad. The result is, I think George will get the TKO, mate. I think you can do it. I believe in George's power, and I think moving up to featherweight from the bantamweight division is going to do him the world good. I mean, look at the size of him, he's bantamweight, but he's 5'8", bigger than me, you know what I mean? So it was a sensible decision, and George took it in his stride. I mean, he fought a guy in his last fight. What's his name now? Oh, mate, he's a Spanish guy, yeah? And he'd lost to Ryan Farag over 6 rounds, so not by over 4 rounds, over 6 rounds by a point. That says a lot. You know, when you come in at a weight corner and you lose by a point, sometimes you feel a bit hard done by. I know myself with the lads who I have, and I think, wow, it says a lot. George got in there, dropped the kid, and beat him every round, and outclassed him, mate. He just didn't look good, he looked fucking exceptional, you know what I mean? And that was his first fight of featherweight, so, mate, we're happy days, you know what I mean? We're going,
yeah. First time on TV televised show as well. Yeah, you know,
it was really great. Good performance. This is a different proposition against Zahid. He's a good fighter.
Yeah.
You know, you're a good fighter. It's two young pros going in early together.
It's good. I like
what you're doing there, Kieran.
Yeah, definitely.
It's good. So, looking at Zahid and what you've seen of him, how do you see the fight panning out for you?
And to be honest with you, I'm just going to control it from the first bell. I don't see it going any other way. With what Kieran and they are doing with me, you know, I have all the confidence and I know I've got the ability to make the fight go the way I want. So if it goes by a knockout, then that's what it is, isn't it? You know. So I just know that the belt's coming home with me.
Have you been enjoying the charge, your pro career? You know, I've been turned over. You know, and going into some fights as well. You know, that year was early on. Really
tough. Hey, yeah, that's all I can say. Yeah, look, yeah. When we speak about that, I don't want to put him because he's a little thing here, but all it is, Chris, is like I say, I believe George Bidding probably with a better caliber opponent than Zahid, you know what I mean? And like, with a win 7, loss 2, drew 1, mate, we don't call them losses, we call them lessons, you know what I mean? He avenged one of the defeats. You know what I mean? We never got the rematch with Lewis Norman, but he grown out the division. We can't make the bantamweight. Lewis Norman's still operating at bantamweight. He don't want to go down there. You know what I mean? We don't need to go down that road. But he avenged one of the defeats, and he got fair play because he did it. You know what I mean? Won the challenge belt with it, and it was good, mate. You know what I mean? To say, look,
Lewis Norman's experience. I mean, you went with him,
it was my fifth fight, and I think it was his 17th or something, but. You look at the people he's been in with, you know, Andrew Salby.
Yeah, and Charlie Edwards, yeah.
Yeah, you know, so I stepped up, you know, and I believed in myself then, and I just fell short.
And you know what, it's done us no harm at all, it's like I say, it's a lesson learned from my behalf as well. Look, maybe it didn't need to go in that fight that early, but look, we're not asked about a bit of a loss, you know what I mean? A loss is a lesson, you know what I mean? People need to get out of their heads, oh yeah, I'm lost, it's over and all that, mate. It's fucking stupid, it does me head in, you know what I mean? Because it's not, this is boxing, this is what people are paying for entertainment, not paying for some bullshit record against some shit journeyman, and that's not disrespecting journeyman, that's just saying, look, I know guys on the circuit, because I do operate the circuit a lot, weekly, and I know some journeymen don't come to fight, they come to tuck up and get the money, and it's as a paying fan, do you want to watch that? No, not with the ticket price, and like I said, the ticket price is the ticket price, and that's no disrespect to promoters, because everyone's got a price and everyone, it's dear, you know what I mean? It's expensive and there's not a lot of money to be made, you know what I mean? So it's that.
No, it's built the character that's been getting in there. He knows what it's like to suffer a defeat. And,
yes.
And the main thing is he's straight back in there, wanting to again, you know, it's
definitely.
And that's the main thing.
We've got Zahid here as well now. Do you want to grab him now? Yes.
Now, we've just been speaking with George. Obviously, you know, you're George's trainer, yeah. Promoter, but, you know, you've
got... Just his manager. I'm just his manager. Nathan Farrell trains George Brennan. That's
yeah,
yeah, Nathan's doing really good with him.
Yeah. Now, we've got a good fight here.
Yes.
Two young, ambitious fighters fighting for the central area title.
Yeah.
It's a proper fight for a central area title. I mean, you're unbeaten, Z.
Yeah.
Just spoke to John. He's really, really confident about winning. He feels he's had, you know, the losses he's had and that kind of stuff and the experience he's had has stand him in good stead. From your point of view, how do you see the fight going with George?
Well, I'm glad that he's confident because that show is going to bring the fight to me and that, you know, it's going to be entertainment. Obviously, I don't want to get too much away, but obviously, I just see me winning, obviously. I'm training hard. I've just come off an injury. I had an operation in January, recovered now, and I'm training full time. We've got like, what, is it 9 weeks now or something like that?
Yeah,
I've got 9 weeks now, more than enough time, yeah.
You're unbeaten in 13 fights. This will be your 14th fight.
Yeah, unbeaten in 13 fights. Now, time to step it up, and George is a big step up from the opponents that I've had in the past, and vice versa for him too. So, yeah, it's going to be a brilliant show, to be honest.
Fair play, Claire, and it's another good fight you've put together.
Mate, it's definitely one of the ones I'm really excited about, like, because I know that. Like I say, I do think George wins the fight, but I know that Zahid, he's gonna, like I say, he's gonna, mate, we've heard it all before, they're all both gonna bring their A game, and look, there's a lot on the line for both of the lads, you know what I mean? Another defeat for George could be like he'd be looking at himself like thinking, am I really that good? Can I really go that far? And I think the same for Zaid, he'd be like, look, it'd be a bit down in the dumps if he lost the fight. So look, you got two kids there now who are bringing the Ray game, and like I say, mate, it's going to be entertainment. Like Zaid said, it's going to be entertainment, and mate, that's what people are paying for, you know what I mean? So if they're paying good money, 35 quid for the ticket, look, Zaid's got tickets, George got tickets, mate. They're both going to bring their support, and he's going to be a lot up from Bradford, so mate, he's going to feel right at home. He's boxed there before. You boxed at the Bolton before,
yeah,
no?
Yeah,
he's boxed at the Bolton before. It was on Acid Valley show, that, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yes, he boxed at Acid Valley show, I remember, because I was there, and like I say, I've seen Zaid a few times. He poses a good threat to George. If anything, it more be 60-40 in his favour. He's got the record. I know George's got the home advantage, but look, it is what it is, you know what I mean? It's a genuine 50-50 fight. Let's get it done.
Looking forward to it, Zaid.
Yeah, me too. Can't wait. It's been a while now, so... Yeah, man, can't wait to get in that ring.
So you've had your ups and downs with injuries and stuff like that.
Yeah, hopefully we've got that sorted now. Yeah, I've been training, it's working. I feel like, you know, the operation's definitely working now. We'll find out when we get the 8-ounce gloves on. But that's not going to stop me from throwing any punches.
Fair play to you, fair play to Job. Yeah. Fair play for making it, Kieran.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
Yeah,
thanks, Will.
Thank you. Kieran, another one of your boxers who's on the bill on the night, introduced us to Reese, and you know, he's 6-1 now, you say?
6-1, mate. Reese McMillan. He's a legend. He was actually my second pro fighter. Signed up when after Darryl Sharp signed up, and he's been doing really well.
And Reese, you stepped in with Adam Little, former English champion, early in your career. You suffered that one loss, but you know, gallant effort from you, and good getting in there as well. Well, that's one thing, Kieran.
That's about a year from now, isn't it?
You know what? Well, last September it was, wasn't it? Yeah. So it'd be like nearly a year to the day where he gets back in the ring again here. But it's been a bit busy since, like. But all it is, mate. Reese has struggled with his tickets for that one fight, yeah, and we said, fuck it, I got a phone call, there's some money here, there's an opportunity to box on ITV4, mate. Fucking hell, Reese flew at it, mate, you know what I mean? And then he got in there, from my side of things, mate, it's not the fucking, like I said, that's not the end of the world, mate. You got him with a fucking, mate. How many other people at 4-0 getting with Adam Little? There's no one who, you know what I mean? This guy's a legend, you know what I mean? He got in there and he fucking, mate, it'd give him a fucking hard time, you know what I mean? And I think Adam Little would actually say to you, like, he did fucking, mate, he got a fucking few cracks around the fucking ear. Reese put up a fight, and Reese wasn't ready for that. But fuck it, mate, it is what it is. It's boxing, you know what I mean? Sometimes we fight, and look, we all want to be fucking Floyd Mayweather, but it's just not happening, mate, you know what I mean? We're not all going to be 50 and all. Let's put some entertaining fights on, get in there and become a better fighter. That's what he's done with it. He's become a better fighter from the experience of fighting Adam Little. That's what I believe, you know what I mean? I believe, like Darryl Sharp, for instance, he's fighting fucking these top kids all the time, and I'm like, mate, why does he seem to fucking do, like, Darryl look really good, and some of these novice pros don't really look that good, and they might even know like 8-0 and 10-0 and 13-0 and stuff like that, and you're like, hang on a minute, the level of opposition you're fighting brings the best out in you, and look, it's not a loss, it's a lesson, mate, you know what I mean? And that's that, you know what I mean?
Definitely. You see it like that, Reese.
Yeah, definitely, yeah. It's like his early in career, like, but the amount I've learned from that fight, unbelievable, like himself and that. And hopefully I get it back one day. Mm. Hopefully.
How do you see it? Just, you know, your pro career up to now, how have you sort of found it, adapting to it, and you know, like you said, that's the
I love the pro game, yeah. I love fighting, just been a bit stop start here and there, but yeah,
You don't train with Kieran already, he just manages you.
I didn't train with Kieran at first, but like I say, it's a bit far for me, especially working and stuff.
He's from Morecambe, is he?
Yeah, he's in Morecambe, yeah.
There's a lot to travel, innit?
So you're training. We're looking forward to this show. You've not got an opponent yet.
Yeah, it's in Brarias. He's fighting for six. It's going to be six threes.
Okay.
So it's like a like. look, you're not really a step up in opposition when he's been in with the likes of Adam Little and stuff like that, but look, he's going to get his six rounds out, and you know that, you know, like Brad Riaz, he's going to be bringing in six rounds, and look, yeah, if Reece did like get rid of him before, and then fuck me, he sent out statements to the boxing, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And the one thing about Reece is what I put the other day is he's never in a dull fight, and it's always a good fight, you know what I mean? And that's what I want. I want fighters like Reece McMillan. He's a top fighter. He's a top kid. He come to my son's christening. He flew all the way up here. You know what I mean? He didn't have to. And we're mates. You know what I mean? And he's been watching Love Island.
What's your ambitions, Reece, in the game? Where do you want to sort of?
In the game, right? I've always promised my uncle when I was younger I'd like to win a British title. Like, he passed away a couple of months ago, so, and I promised him I'd never get beat again, so gotta try and stick to that, innit?
Mm-hmm. Told me as well, like, he wants to be like Idris, who was in the Love Island, you know, the professional boxer who got
I don't know this Love Island, everyone keeps talking about it, I've not seen it.
No, so bullshit, don't lie.
I don't know what he's telling.
I'd love to win a British title and that, but I just love fighting, so. Just keep seeing where we're going.
What's your background in boxing? How did you first, did you have amateur career?
Mate, it's beat a few good kids in amateur.
Yeah, a lot of them are my weight now, to be honest. I think in top
who
four.
Who have you fought in the amateurs?
Luke Evans, Lenny Evans, he's from Wales. Who else have we boxed?
Mate, it's a box of few good kids, and yeah, you know, to be fair, you beat Luke Evans, didn't you?
Yeah,
you put it out there, beat Luke Evans away. And Luke Evans, I know he's been through a bit of trouble with the attack and stuff like that, but look, he was a prospect of the year for Box Nation, I think it was, wasn't he? One of the prospects of the year, you know what I mean? But look, we don't call people out and shit like that. Look, if the paths ever collided again, mate, I'm sure it'd be a good fight, but look, I think they're both doing their own thing. Yeah. And look, we'll see where we are, you know what I mean? But look,
fights,
he said, mate, we're slow burning. Reece is only young, you know what I mean? How old are you now, bro?
Yeah, 22.
22 years old, he's a baby, you know what I mean? And one thing what I say about Reece is he's a strong kid, you know what I mean? So whoever he fights in the future, and we said that, look, we think that Reece will be a good 12 round fighter, and that's what we're doing, mate. We're gradually building him up, you know. I know we might have thrown him in the deep end with Adam Little,
but we feel
like he's learnt loads from that, and mate, it's done him the world of good, you know what I mean?
What was the difference in that fight when you know fighting your earlier fights on the journeyman, if you like, and you know, and then going in with someone who was that experienced? What was that?
Like, it was
subtle differences.
I feel like it was just that. What you just said, the experience. You know what I mean? That's all I feel it was. But
probably fitness a bit, but
yeah.
How did you feel in there with him? And was it certain little things he did? And
I never thought. When I was in there, I never thought he had a big punch on him out. And like when he was hitting me, I thought I'd just walk through him, but he got caught with a body shot, don't you?
It is what it is, and Adam Little got taught off the best man for the body shots that were Ricky out, and you know what I mean? So look at
it.
Fair play to you for
did also get in that fucking.
I'd love to get fight again, a couple more fights.
Two days notice, he jumped in that fight, you know what I mean? Yeah. So I just sent me out to Therese and just say fuck it.
Big opportunity, wasn't it?
Yeah, fuck it. Look at
it again, first round.
You roll the dice, you gamble, don't you? You know what I mean? He thrown himself in there, and look, he didn't throw himself in there, I threw him in there, but I feel like I've done a fucking good job with that, you know what I mean? I'll take all the blame for the loss or whatever you want to fucking call it. I had a lesson, but I feel like it's done me the world of good, mate. And you know what?
It was good, mate.
I feel like it's a win win situation for me, you know what I mean? And for Reece, I think it was just fucking. Look, we weren't perfect. If it were perfect, it would have beat him. But look, he went in there, showing a massive audience who Reece McMillan is, and look, he's still delivering now. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, you roll the dice. You roll him again, September 29th. Looking forward to seeing you back out, Reece.
Yeah.
All the very best, mate. Nice to meet you. Okay, so it's been a busy evening in the gym. Spoke to some of the lads there, and. You know, everyone's looking forward to this show, and I'm sure obviously you're looking forward to it. How did you get around to getting it at the Macron? It's a great state, great place to hold a boxing show.
Yeah, well, I mean, obviously, Chris, we had a few problems at the middle of the arena last time, which we've sorted out. It's all sorted now. Been a bit disappointed with them, really, you know what I mean, the actual venue. But look, I don't want to go into that now. It's all done, it's dusted. the Macron Stadium, mate. I boxed there when I boxed there 3 or 4 times when I boxed there for my area title, and obviously it'd be more fitting. Like, I was looking for a venue what's applicable to all, really. All the lads are like sort of round in and around the areas and stuff like that. So I thought, you know what, hang on. We was there in May with George Brennan and Reese McMillan, and they both boxed really well. And mate, the fucking venue were really good. And I thought, you know what, let's have a meeting ourselves here. We went up there, had a meeting. It's expensive, mate. It's not cheap, but I'm rolling the dice, you know what I mean? And the lads are rolling the dice with a fight, so let's do it, you know what I mean? I seen Eddie Earn, Eddie Earn on Instagram inspired me, mate. He put 5 years ago, everyone thought I was mad, and I did the Wembley Stadium, and they had 76,000 with Carl Froch and all that, and I was like, wow. He rolled the dice, you know what I mean? That's rolling the dice. And I thought, you know what? It's all right, I can go to the bowlers, I can go to Middleton Arena, I can try and play it safe all the time. But if I really want to do something in the game, then let's go for it, you know what I mean? I went, let's roll the dice and let's go for it. And that's what I feel like I'm doing. It's, like I say, it's expensive. Every penny counts, and every person who buys a ticket is going to be more greatly appreciated, any more than it has been in the past. Just because, like I say, mate, it's a day do. But look, do we get any money's worth anyway? You know what I mean? 100%. Look, the fight's second to none for another small show. Say it's probably nearly triple the capacity of the Middleton Arena. We're looking to fill it up. The lads are all good. They're all got good fights, and they're all ready for their little steps in their own careers. And look, I'm ready to get it on. Let's do it. You know what I mean? The more support I can get myself as well, the better, because every penny counts, and it's not massive money to me. I've spoken before to you, Chris, about small promoting and stuff like that. There's not millions to be made, mate. If there's a few quid to be made, then let's try and make it. But look, I don't think there's not millions to be made, and I hope people don't think I am fucking Rockefeller, because I'm not, mate. Not yet, anyway. You know what I mean? And I certainly won't be doing it. If I had ever become Rockefeller, it wouldn't certainly be not be through promoting, because it is an hard game, mate. You know what I mean? You know, I'm doing all right with it, mate. You know what I mean? I'm getting by, and I know what I'm doing. And I had a meeting with Jed Mason, and he said, let's go for quality rather than quantity this year, and that's what we've done. We've put 2 quality events on up to now. We've got a 3rd quality event coming up, and maybe 1 more, maybe 2 more before Christmas. You know, let's have a little look, you know what I mean? But as far as I'm concerned, I'm doing a good job with it, and mate, I don't want to be put off by stupid idiots, you know what I mean? And that's all I can say about the incident, as it is. It's done now.
Yeah. No, it's good to see, Kieran, how far you've come, and you know, you're still enjoying it and enthusiastic about it.
Mate, you know what? I've never been more enthusiastic about it. I think it's growing on me, this boxing thing, you know what I mean? I come into the gym with a smile on my face, and you know what? I think it's all panning out really good.
Mm. Don't seem long ago, we were starting with your central area title, and we're taking pictures on your dad's truck.
Yeah,
do you remember?
It doesn't feel like 2 minutes ago, you know, and it's mad, because I just think, I always like to say to the lads, you know, we were boxing, I'm like, mate, you want to soak it in, because this ship sails quick, you know what I mean? And it does, mate. I know it was a bit quicker for me than any other one, but look, it's just mad, mate. You know what I mean? I remember being at Bobby Rimmer's house with Terry Flanagan, sat watching Juan Diaz versus Juan Manuel Marquez for the WBO lightweight title. Wow. 6 years later, fuck me, who goes and wins the WBO lightweight title? Our man, fucking Terry Flanagan. So, mate, look, it's mad. Life's mad. And that's what it is, mate. It's just a mad, mad game.
Kieran, I wish you all the best for this show. We'll catch up again soon. Great to see you, mate, tonight.
Thank you, Chris. See you again soon. Cheers. Thank you.